extra lives if our characters die.
Welcome back to For the King, everyone. That's we unfortunately lost our good buddy King X Gamer. We had to fill in his spot with Mr. Gutman.
Pickle Ferret.
The Ferret Man. As you guys know him from Dauntless. You guys ready for this train wreck of an episode we're gonna have?
Yeah, Gut doesn't have any experience with this game, so it's gonna be a huge learning curve since we are basically in the end game right now. And he is using equipment that he doesn't have any familiarity with.
Oh, wait, you're right. Oh, dear God. Yeah, we were getting close to finishing this game last time we played.
Yeah.
I got this.
Okay.
Right, let us know
if you want to look Dark at Souls Master equipment, here.
And we'll get going.
Oh, I'm already ready. I was scrolling through while we were talking.
Alright, so if you look above your character, you'll see icons with slashes through them. Those are your immunities.
So I'm immune to fire...
You're immune to water, which... water is basically what happens to wipe away every single one of your immunities. If you are not immune to water, it doesn't matter what your other immunities are. You're immune to getting things stolen from you. You're immune to shock, which is basically a guaranteed miss on one of your damage rolls. You're immune to bleed, and the eyeball is the worst one out of all of them because it affects your base stats. That one is cursed. You never want to have a chance to get cursed.
So they're not like Dark Souls. Don't get cursed.
Pretty much. Chris is immune to freezing, which makes your character more fragile. It doesn't slow you down, it just makes your character take more damage when hit. He is immune to burn as well. I am immune to water, bleed, freeze, burn, curse, and shock.
Mine's water, electricity, ice, fire, and what is that?
Curse.
Oh yeah, curse.
Curse.
Alrighty then.
Oh yeah, and prices for weaponry and stuff inflate big time. Okay, I need to look at my items because I really don't know what all I had that I was going to try and pass to you guys. Oh yeah, I had, let's see. So, Chris, if you'll be able to inform me, in your last video, what was I talking about what equipment was I talking about trying to pass to you guys?
Oh dear God, I don't know.
Or were you guys trying to pass equipment to me? Because my character can use anything with a man juggling in it.
I think we had some sort of issue with money. I needed a pipe or something, maybe. I might have needed to upgrade something. I know it was me. I don't remember what Matt had to do.
Right?
I know we needed to get more of those, what's it called? The plant that heals you or something?
Yeah, God's Beard.
We needed more of that. I can't think of anything else that I know of. It's been about two weeks.
I'm looking through you guys' equipment right now to see if there's anything that y'all are going to have to pass to me.
Like, I can go B&B real quick and go skim the video if I have to.
Okay, y'all aren't carrying anything that, is for other classes, so y'all are good for now. So we're basically trying to figure out where to go for the Scourge. And, let's see. Wait a second, is this it? I think this is the Scourge right here. If you'll look at where I just marked. That is a level 8. We are currently on par with it, so we're gonna have a bit of a fight on our hands.
Yeah, I'm not doing
okay, so after
if you'll follow my marks right up here, just keep following it up and right there. So basically I'm going to start traveling up this. We were trying to travel up this way to the Scourge anyways at the end of the episode because we had finally found it. I think that's what we were trying to do. Yeah. Let's see. Yeah, this guy, yeah, this this merchant's not carrying anything good, so yeah.
Okay, so I skipped the video, and honestly, I couldn't hear much because I'm already in game with another headset, but
Right.
unfortunately, that video really doesn't help me because I would really have to go into detail and listen to it to find out what we needed.
Right.
Oh, that's right, my turn was skipped for some reason.
Yeah, you ended up walking on a path that skipped your turn. Or on a trap that caused you to get your turn skipped.
Okay, we need to check and see if I have the right pipe. We need to get enough guards beer to do stuff. And I guess we need to head toward the goal and do that last thing we have to do.
Yeah, doing the main missions reduces corruption. If we end up with 3 corruption tokens, the game is over. Oh, and that staff your character is has, if you remember, was because we barely managed to survive the Kraken fight. Yeah, so I'm gonna head up here. I'm gonna let you guys come over to me, so that way we can attempt to fight our way up to the Scourge and kill it before it starts being active.
Okay.
This will give us money, and then we can go from town to town until we see corruption on the timeline.
Oh, he got a good turn on that one. Oh, wait, that's right, because Matt actually had all the good stuff, didn't he?
Yeah, Matt's got the Sanctum of Speed, which will allow him to roll for more movement.
Do you think people really want to know our real names or whatever? Well, not our full name, but at least our, like, nickname.
Sneak, retreat, or fight?
Retreat for now, because he's not able to get towards us. If you ended up fighting, it would just be me and you in the fight.
He's only on 6.
Yeah, but we need all the XP we can get, because in this game, level does matter.
Alrighty.
If you aren't at least 1 or 2 levels higher than something, you're gonna get beaten down hard.
Get beat. I'm not gonna get pulled into that. Oh, we're going up to that. Oh, you were.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. Now, you should still be able to get pulled into the fight, but so now
okay,
it's.
So how do I?
You press the window and window button on your controller to end your turn.
Also known as the reset button.
I still call it the back button. I just looked at the picture on the button and it reminded me of the picture in picture button on TV remotes. I just still call it the back button.
Where exactly are we heading?
We're heading up towards the Scourge.
Where is
because
this?
There are 2 towns nearby it.
So the Scourge is the one with the hag in it?
What?
I don't know what I'm looking at. You know what, I'm just gonna I'm gonna move and just follow you where you go.
Move over here.
Oh, my turn's pretty much ended now.
I mean, you can, if you press the triggers, you can zoom way out, you know? Oh, that's a Stonehenge, which is an intelligence check. So that is all you.
Okay. We're gonna let Mr. Gutman take over for his turn and do what he needs to do.
Alright.
Gutman. That's a name for someone. Mr.
Okay,
Gutman.
So if you see underneath the Bone Wizard, you'll see a purple shield that indicates magical damage resistance. If there's a blue shield, then there's a physical damage resistance. Also, you're gonna want to kill the thief first, because he's gonna be taking our stuff. Like, he can steal every single bit of money we have, and then run.
I like how I didn't get pulled into this.
I mean, yeah, I knew you wouldn't.
Oh, he dodged. That's so messed up.
This game's weird. Hey.
Get stabbed.
You're immune to fire. No, you're not.
And yeah,
that's the one resistance you don't have. Okay, you gotta kill him right now because he just stole every single bit of gold.
He's gonna take the gold. Oh no. Oh, come on.
He's gonna run away with it all.
That's 400 gold gone, too. Oh. If I was there with you guys, he would have been dead.
Yeah, it's no big deal.
Because I would have had that extra turn to kill him.
So as it stands right now, that is plus 10 party armor, combat use only. So that is going to be for end game, once we reach the final boss. If we manage to get that far. Also, on your turn, you're going to want to smoke a God's Beard so you can restore your health.
I'm gonna move myself where everyone can see your health bar, Mr. Master Death. I'm like blocking your character's view and everything on the video. Like, I'm just sitting there all pretty looking, like, nope, I'm gonna move over.
There. Now you're gonna wanna move in this direction towards right here.
What is that?
Just don't go inside it yet.
It's like a weird, a creepy looking smoke cave or something.
Yeah, that's the scourge that's about to happen if we don't kill it.
It's a dirt cave.
I will do my best to get over there.
Alright. It is level 8, and we are on par with it.
Let me have a man. Oh, what are you waiting for?
Yeah, you gotta end your turn.
Oh yeah, he's gotta hit the back button on there. Okay.
That's gonna be something I'm gonna have to remember to do.
Oh, don't worry, it's not just you, it was me too. Okay, so I can hit this Stonehenge thing.
Yeah, it's an intelligence check.
I actually have the intelligence for this.
I think you can use focus to increase your odds, but I'm not sure.
No, it doesn't let me.
Alright.
I got it though.
There you go, you got max focus. Now you're gonna wanna make your way up towards us.
I'll end my turn there and then make my way there in the next one.
Alright.
As I lean back and drink some tea.
Copter attack. It's just one thing. It's gonna have magical damage resistance. So.
Oh, it's just a sexy looking Cthulhu.
God, it's a mind flayer.
Mind bender.
Usually the AoE attacks deal less damage than the single target stuff. It's immune to burning, freeze, and it's immune to all basic damage status effects.
I actually have a Funko Pop of a Mind Flayer.
Alright, it's gonna hurt us. Oh, awesome. Alright.
Oh, I didn't get included on this either.
It popped up as I was traversing.
Oh, this was one of those random fights.
Pass the money to me.
Pass? Or sure?
Yeah.
Yeah, you do pass. You give the money to me and him because we have something on our characters that will allow us to make the money get doubled or something.
It'll allow a percentage increase to money to money taken.
Yeah, that.
All right, you're gonna want to go around that thing. You're gonna want to end your turn without moving at all. You'll recover some health for each movement block you haven't used. and Chris is going to want to go around those enemies and get as close to us as possible. Also, before you end your turn, you're going to want to smoke a God's Beard and try and get close enough to us so I can pass you one.
Okay. Inventory. God's Beard. Use. Gotcha. Back. And now in my turn. Oh wait, no, I can yep. I could actually start this, couldn't I?
Yeah, you've got enough focus to get an ambush.
Oh, we don't have ambush option.
Oh yeah, it's a scourge. We have no choice but to fight fair and square.
This is an ancient quarry, dude.
It's still a scourge, though.
Well, here we go.
Deimos, my memory is long, yet you are strange to me. No matter, I will enjoy dismantling you into chaos.
Well, that just sounds like a fun Friday afternoon.
Okay, so he's resisting magic and physical damage, and he's immune to every status ailment. So this is basically a war of attrition.
Oh, shit.
And since since it's just a single target, you don't really need to use AoE attacks.
Of course, it would be immune.
I tried to pierce through its armor. It's gonna hurt big time.
Okay, I forgot what I was... How do I do... Okay.
Just go for whatever damages the most.
Whatever's the most?
Whatever damages it the most. Because it's resisting 16 magic damage. And it's gonna do... Oh.
I dodged.
Nice.
Oh, yay.
Ow.
Oh, that sucks.
That was a shitty roll.
Yeah, this game relies heavy on RNG for all things.
Oh, well then you really- oh look, his life is 69.
Single target? No.
Oh, you suck. You suck so bad, Mr. Boulderman. Dayton Deimos.
Do you have a golden root in your items? Because that'll restore some of your focus, so you can use at least one to guarantee a good hit.
How do I check for items?
Should be a choice.
It might be like the Y option for your inventory or some sort of button that'll...
I'll figure it out once it's my turn again, so I can tell you what button you need to hit. No, right now we have enough
grasp,
health. What you're looking for is a golden root.
I got none of that.
Alright, then just take a normal attack. You're using the one that inflicts a status ailment on it. You gotta do one that is damage dealing.
Let's see here. I'm kinda curious to see- oh wait, that doesn't do anything to us. I could throw snowballs at him.
It's immune to freeze.
It would stun him, from what it says.
It's immune. He's immune to stun as well. He's immune to everything.
Oh, he can go suck a pickle.
He's immune
big
to
fat
bleed,
juicy pickle too.
He's immune to bleed, burn, freeze, shock, stun, and what?
Well, ain't no one told you to be God here. Oh hey, I might be able to end it here.
Almost. Yeah. Almost.
There goes your sanctum. If you die, the sanctum that you have will burn itself in order to revive you.
Didn't you guys give me that just so I would stay alive in case something happened?
Yeah. These books of lore are meta progression, by the way.
Nice.
Ooh.
Is that better than what you're currently wearing, though?
I don't know.
It should pop up.
It should have an option that says compare.
Yeah, it'll tell you if it's better.
Because it's plus 4 armor, plus 3, plus 15 max health, and it's got stun, burn, and freeze immunity.
Mine has 3 damage reflection, 3 physical damage, and 3 and steel immunity.
Hey Gus, think of this game of kind of like a combination of RPG / Dungeons and Dragons or something. It's a weird concept.
This literally wouldn't be any use to me.
The skull?
Yeah.
Alright, then keep it for us.
It's an artifact. Yeah. Maybe I could use it.
You're already wearing an artifact. You're wearing that witch's hair. What's giving you all of your immunities. it's what is giving you every single one of your immunities. That alone is keeping your immunities up, whereas me and Gus have to have several things equipped to have us give us our immunities.
Very true, very true. One of you take that then. Like, figure out who is it good for.
Let's see. My hood that I'm wearing is giving us all shock immunity. So if I take that away, then that'll end up paralyzing one of our rolls if we get shocked. So I can't equip that, so I'm just going to collect it for now. Oh yeah, Gus, by the way, before you get this nasty surprise, I'm going to tell you right now. There are monsters in this game that will break items. There are acid slimes that will dissolve an item at random, and then there are mimics and stuff that will basically just break the items in general.
Yeah, so
I've seen enough hentai to know where this is going.
Oh no. Okay, so but I was gonna say a little story. I was playing D&D with my friends, and one of them decided, let's just encounter a freaking slime. Oh my gosh, that was fun. That's terrible fun, but like, it wasn't bad, but we hated it. Like, it would burn the clothes off of our characters, and our weapons would melt and stuff.
Don't mess with the slime.
It's just disturbing. Like, that's why I think of this game really close to D&D. It's, like, really close to it, but it's not exact.
Hasn't the anime That Time I Got Reincarnated as a Slime taught you anything? Don't mess with slimes.
I haven't seen that anime.
You need to see it, then. Oh, what's that down there?
Look at me, I've turned myself into an anime, and I haven't even seen that anime. What's wrong with me?
Oh yeah, before I move, Chris, if you want to pass your money to me, there are 2 towns that I can manage to get to.
But it's your turn.
Yeah, it is my turn. I can get to the towns and see what they have and relay the information to y'all.
Oh wait, that's right, I can give you money when it's not my turn. I forgot about that. Yeah.
And I'm going to go ahead and use a single golden root to restore my focus. So that way I can sneak by these monsters.
So you're going to the town?
Yeah, I'm going to Wendero.
Wendero. Here, take my gold.
Shut up and take my money.
Shut up and take my money!
Oh, this will pull us all in. But, this thing is going to poison us, and none of us have poison immunity. Poison isn't just damage over time. It lowers every single one of your stats. So I'm just going to sneak by it.
Oh, I see what happened. You were trapped because it was in the way.
Yeah. All right. Godbeard is currently 73 per.
We might need to worry about getting anything that will revive us if we get knocked out.
Yeah.
Because we need to replace that one.
Let's see. Chris, you have the Glacier Tome, right?
I believe so.
Alright. But what are you, what is your weapon? Like, what is your bow called? Firebow? What's its damage?
I like how my menu is stuck on the screen and I can't get it off.
I do 13 damage.
Right, there's a bow for 200, they're called Dragon Bow. Plus 4 evasion, plus 50% damage against flying. 24 physical damage.
Okay, nice. Mm-hmm.
Okay,
right, so I'm gonna take the bow, but first I'm gonna check the plus, see what they have. There's a reduced chaos one. What's
I'm
the
gonna do a
us?
Quick video break, and we'll be back.
Alright. Oh, there.